Wait, you're filming, right? Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Cammy. You're going to cut that out, right? Yeah. Hi, I'm Cammy, and I'll be your host today on the show about diabetes. The purpose of this video is not for you to hear what we're saying and go, yeah, I guess that's cool, but for you to really pay attention to what we're saying and learn from it. So, in the future, anyone says,
So, will I, like, get diabetes from eating this?
No, but let's just get started on what diabetes is.
Bill Nye the Science Guy.
Property of matter.
Bill, T minus seven seconds.
Bill Nye the Science Guy.
Hello, my name is Leila, and I'll be subbing in today for my buddy Bill Nye. And today what we're going to be discussing is, what is diabetes? And diabetes all starts in an organ located here in your digestive system called the pancreas. The pancreas is around the size of a glasses container, and it's part of a bigger system called the endocrine system. The endocrine system is in charge of your metabolism, your hormones, puberty, waking up, and so much more. Your pancreas is in charge of secreting insulin into the bloodstream whenever sugar levels go high. When you eat anything with carbs in it and sugars in it, including a healthy snack like pretzels and orange juice, your sugar levels go up. So, on a test, you want to score 100, or you're at least aiming to score 100. So on a blood sugar test, similarly, your number that you want to get is 100. So whenever you eat anything with carbs and sugar again, so anything besides water, your blood sugar levels will go up. So if you eat like one pretzel, some orange juice, it's going to be around here, but your pancreas is going to secrete insulin to bring it back down to that 100 level that you want. That's what happens in a normal body. However, in a body with diabetes, the more you eat, there is no insulin being produced. So your sugar levels just get higher and higher and higher and higher the more you eat. And that's what diabetes is.
So for instance, let's say that all the yellow balls in Pac-Man was food of some sort. The more you eat, the higher blood sugar gets. However, once you get insulin in your system, aka the blue balls, the insulin level in your blood gets lower. And for diabetics, the body can no longer produce insulin, and therefore their blood sugars cannot go lower on its own. Get it?
Oh, hey, you're back. Well, now that we know the basic things about diabetes, let's learn more about what can affect your blood sugar levels.
So as you now know, eating can bring your blood sugar higher. However, exercising can bring your blood sugar lower. Other things like puberty, stress, hormones, and pretty much everything else in life can also affect your blood sugar.
And sometimes, even if diabetics perfectly follow all the rules of eating healthy and exercising, their blood sugar levels can still vary irrationally from high to low and low to high. So, what are the common signs of low and high blood sugars?
Symptoms of low blood sugar are shakiness, sweatiness, dizziness, sudden behavior change, hunger, weakness, headache, and nervousness or upsetness. Common high blood sugar symptoms include thirst, extreme hunger, sleepiness, blurry vision, and frequent urination. Thousand-year-old Egyptian hieroglyphics describe diabetes. Greek physicians 2,000 years ago described it as a melting down of flesh and limbs. In the 1920s, Frederick Banting discovered insulin that made diabetes treatable. In fact, Frederick Banting won the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 1923 for this discovery.
Currently, Currently, diabetics who are trying to lower their blood sugar levels only have to inject themselves with insulin. This is all thanks to scientist Frederick Banting, who discovered the use of insulin as a medication for diabetes. Now, diabetics can freely inject themselves with insulin using the shot, the pen, which is multiple shots, easier to use and lasts much longer, or some use the holy grail of diabetes, the insulin pump, which allows diabetics to regulate their blood sugar levels by pressing a few simple buttons. Instead of injecting themselves 4 to 8 times a day by using the shot or the pen, people who use the insulin pump only have to inject themselves once every 2 to 3 days.
He's just like paperwork, but harder to read.
Diabetes mellitus is a metabolic disorder caused by the inability of the pancreas to produce enough insulin for the body, or when the body fails to use insulin properly. Insulin is the hormone responsible for regulating the body's blood sugar level. If insulin is insufficient or is not used effectively, blood sugar increases. This condition is called hyperglycemia. Hyperglycemia commonly occurs with uncontrolled diabetes and can lead to damage to the eyes, kidneys, nerves, and blood vessels. An acute, severe disruption of the blood sugar level can be fatal. The types of diabetes are type 1 diabetes, type 2 diabetes, and gestational diabetes. Type 1 diabetes is also known as insulin-dependent or childhood-onset diabetes. It is a condition wherein there is inadequate insulin produced in the body. Type 2 diabetes, on the other hand, is also called non-insulin-dependent or adult-onset diabetes. This type of diabetes is brought by the body's failure to use insulin effectively. Gestational diabetes is characterized by hyperglycemia that occurred initially during pregnancy. The cause of type 1 diabetes can be abnormal genes in the body, and there is no available information about prevention. Type 2 diabetes, on the other hand, is the product of an unhealthy lifestyle and is related to excessive body weight, unhealthy food selection, and prolonged inactivity. The cause of gestational diabetes is linked to the effect of fluctuating hormones of pregnancy on the body. Symptoms of diabetes can be frequent and excessive urination, extreme feeling of thirst, weight loss, vision changes, itching, and fatigue. Treatment of type 1 diabetes requires administration of insulin on a daily basis. Type 2 diabetes and gestational diabetes treatment involves proper diet, exercise, oral medication, and insulin in some cases. In both types of diabetes, non-smoking is essential to prevent damage due to diabetes. Type 2 diabetes can be prevented through living a healthy lifestyle that includes attaining and sustaining a healthy body weight, being physically fit and active, and eating a well-balanced and healthy meal. Your general practitioner can give you more information about the disorder and its possible treatments.
Everyone, please welcome Chelsea to the show. Chelsea, thanks for joining us. When were you diagnosed with diabetes?
When I was 9 in 1994.
And I want to remind everyone that there is a difference between type 1 and type 2 diabetes. Type 1 diabetes, which is what Chelsea has, occurs when your body stops making insulin. Say you're eating an apple. Well, what's an apple? Carbohydrates, sugars. When you eat that apple, your body begins to break down those carbohydrates so that it can absorb that sugar into your bloodstream. Meanwhile, your pancreas secretes insulin. And the insulin will then attach to the sugar in the bloodstream, also known as the glucose, which you're going to see here. And what that does is the insulin shepherds that glucose into your body's cells, into your brain cells, into your muscles, so you can think, so you can run, so your heart can beat. And I want everyone to look at this demo. Pretend this is your blood vessel And in there, those are blood glucose molecules, okay? In someone with type 1 diabetes, there is no insulin to go in there and grab that glucose and pull it into your cells. A normal person, the insulin will come in, attach itself, and pull it into your cells, just like that. In someone with type 2 diabetes, you'll still make insulin, but your body is less responsive to it. So the insulin may be coursing through your blood, but your body's cells don't, they're not as responsive to it. So even though you have insulin, you still end up with a lot of glucose in your bloodstream. What I need you to recognize, Chelsea, is that diabetes does not have to be a death sentence. It doesn't have to mean that you're going to lose your vision, lose your kidney function. You have to take charge of it. You should probably stay, a couple more days. Come on, let me change it.
Now you're ready to do a test. First, you'll need to choose a finger to take a sample from. It's best to alternate between fingers as they can become sensitive over time. Remember to always wash your hands with warm, soapy water and dry them thoroughly before you test. Take a test strip from the container and always remember to close the lid tightly. This helps protect the remaining strips. Always check the expiration date on the container. Do not perform a test with expired test strips. Now, insert the test strip, gold end first, into the meter. The meter will beep. Then, a small flashing hourglass symbol will briefly appear on the screen. Then the meter will beep again. And the test strip symbol with a flashing blood drop will appear on the screen. This tells you that the meter is ready to test. When lancing my finger, I always use the side of the finger rather than the tip, as it's more comfortable and less sensitive. Press the pinhole opening on the end of the lancing device firmly against your finger and press the plunger all the way down. One click is all it takes. This will lance your finger. Massage the finger in the direction of the fingertip to help the blood drop form. Now, place the end of the test strip against the drop of blood and let it fill. When enough blood has filled the strip, a small hourglass symbol will flash on the screen to show you that the meter is working. Your blood sugar reading will be ready in 5 seconds. Now you have your test result. It's just that easy. Two important final steps. First, dispose of the used test strip. Then, advance to a fresh lancet by simply pushing the white lever back and forth once. A new lancet is now ready to use the next time you test. Now you can put everything in the carrying case.
My kid might have to go on insulin. And you're going to tell him, yes, the kid also could get a period. We may not even need insulin, called honeymoon period. Is that true?
Yes. The honeymoon period is when the body still produces the remaining insulin that's left in the cells of the pancreas. And it's just enough insulin to usually keep some type of control. Children who are diagnosed with type 1 diabetes experience it, and it can last from 2 months, and it can last to up to a couple of months, sometimes even a year.
And now,
can't keep my hands to myself. No matter how hard I'm trying to, I want you all to myself. Your metaphorical gin and juice. The downs and the uppers keep making love to each other. And I'm trying, 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 trying. All of the downs and the uppers keep making love to each other. And I'm trying, 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 but I can't keep my hands to myself. Hands to myself. Can't keep my hands to myself. Give me
What comes to mind when you think of diabetes? Having diabetes is not quite as simple as taking an injection once in a while and you're sorted. Managing type 1 diabetes requires constant attention. That's 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, or 8,765 hours in the first year of diagnosis. Professor Anders Ericsson from the University of Colorado wrote about the concept of becoming an expert in something after 10,000 hours of doing it. This means that in the first year of diagnosis, we are all well on our way to becoming experts in diabetes. So in terms of tests and injections, that's 13 a day, 91 a week, 403 a month, and 4,836 a year. People often get the types of diabetes confused. We didn't get diabetes because we ate too many sweets or because we're unfit. Type 1 diabetes is an autoimmune condition and just happens. It's as important for us to keep as fit and healthy as everyone else. Sometimes it seems like it could be easier not to bother, but then we're doing this for no one other than ourselves. People often forget that for everything you do, breathing, thinking, moving, and even sleeping, it takes energy. We need to check our blood glucose regularly, as our bodies can't do this for us, or produce insulin, so that's why we need to inject, making everything you do and every time you eat a test of your maths ability and patience, with people staring, asking questions, and making comments. Sometimes the sugar in your blood falls too low. This is called a hypoglycemia, or a hypo. It can make you feel shaky, give you blurred vision and headaches, among other things. Put it this way, it's not the best feeling in the world. To treat a hypo, you need sugary food or drink. Sometimes this isn't always convenient or possible. Getting the balance right with diabetes can be difficult, and you do everything you're supposed to do, and sometimes you still don't get the results you want. People with type 1 diabetes shouldn't let their condition hold them back. Things just require more consideration and preparation. It was once said that to really understand a person, you have to walk a mile in their shoes. But if you really want to understand a person, you just have to talk to them.
Beautiful, and everybody wants a taste. That's why I still get jealous. Google is developing a prototype contact lens that measures glucose levels in tears. The device provides a non-invasive method to track glucose in diabetic patients. A sensor, antenna, and transistor chips are embedded between two contact lenses. The sensor measures glucose levels in tears. The antenna then sends the data to a mobile device. The current prototype generates one reading per second. Developers are also looking to integrate LED lights that flash as soon as glucose levels cross into dangerous thresholds.
Type 1 diabetes destroys the body's own insulin-producing beta cells, so there is no longer a way for the body to provide insulin when it's needed. But what if you could take insulin that would automatically sense your body's blood glucose levels and knew when it was needed and when it wasn't? What if we could develop insulin that was, well, smarter? JDRF is actively pursuing a plan to make this a reality. Currently, insulin is just a lifeline, and while it makes survival possible, it doesn't make it easy. Because without the body's ability to sense when it's needed, those with type 1 must constantly calculate the right dose to administer. This is where the idea of smart insulin comes in. Smart insulin, taken once a day or even once a week, would circulate in the bloodstream, turning on when it's needed and off when it's not. Whether it comes as a pill or an injection, smart insulin would give someone with type 1 perfect glucose control throughout the day, and wouldn't be influenced by what they ate, how hard they exercised, or how stressed they were at work or school. Ultimately, smart insulin could completely eliminate the need to mechanically manage insulin levels, and it's much more than a high-tech dream. Years ago, where others saw risk, JDRF saw opportunity and invested in one of the original ideas for smart insulin. Today, because of JDRF's vision, a global pharmaceutical leader is working on smart insulin, and scientists around the world have responded to JDRF's call for new approaches to the smart insulin idea. Smart insulin could ultimately unshackle people with type 1 diabetes from multiple injections, external devices, and constant vigilance and guesswork of manually dosing insulin. With smart insulin, they could finally keep their type 1 under control without continually monitoring it. But there's still a lot of work to be done here, and we need your help. Support our efforts to make smart insulin a reality, and together, we will reduce the burden of type 1 until we find the cure. Support type 1 research today by making a donation.
Around 80 people a day are diagnosed with type 1 diabetes, meaning that in less than 18 days, our whole school would be type 1 diabetics. So how can you help? Well, you can major in pre-medicine in college, then go to medical school, then have a 3-year residency, and 2-year specialization to become an endocrinologist and then find a cure for type 1 diabetes. Or, if you hear something bad, speak up. Don't let the ignorance continue. It's insulting. 2. Celebrate Diabetes Day on November 14th and promote awareness on the disease. 3. Volunteer at diabetes-related community service events such as the Diabetes Walk at Stroudsburg High School Turf Field on April 24th from 12 to 4. Either donate or volunteer, or both. All proceeds will go to the cure of type 1 diabetes. In fact, that's how we'll leave you, with a video on the promo for the walk.
What is diabetes?
It's when your body's yellow. I can tell.
Isn't it that thing where you're like,
It's when the body doesn't produce enough insulin.
Diabetes is a chronic disease, which is the absence of insulin production, especially type 1 diabetes, which is what this walk is all about.
I'm gonna give you my heart.
apart. I don't care, go on and tear me apart. I don't care if you do. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Cause in the sky, cause in the sky full of stars, I think I saw
certain someone you want to walk for?
My sister.
My name is Taylor McNeil and I want to stop diabetes.
My name is John Shanley and I want to stop diabetes.
What do you think about diabetes?
I want to stop.
Do you?
Yeah.
Why?
Because then she will stop having to take a shot in her butt.
That sounds great. I hope so.
Thank you all for listening and for everyone who helped to produce this initiative. Let's transform the future of our world from type 1 diabetes to type none.
I want to fall in the oceans like we used to do.
I had this thing in the shot the entire time.
What?
This.
Girl. All the shots? Ooh. Hello. Oh, too much. Too much.
Muscovy would fry your life.
You'll do is think you like.
No! Ew! No, it's always just like.
Hi, my name's Cammie, and I'll be your host today on this show about diabetes.
Boy, what you got in your arm?
Ooh, bug.
Centipede.
Thank God.
Inject themselves with insulin. Some people use the holy grail for diabetics. I forgot to call him a scientist.
It's fine.
He deserves it.
He's too good for me!
Currently, for I'm gonna wait till you're done.
I'm sorry.
So you're done. Being difficult. Thanks to scientist Frederick Lamar.
And it's starting with the L. It's like Lopak.
Lopak. Leper.
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 All right.
No, neither of those. A leopard is a different